Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era, ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. Hello Galactic Family, dear ones, from the beginning of time there have been clear moments when the portals of awakening open for individuals to advance. The 11-11 Gateway is a collective, high vibrational portal opening to assist the evolution of consciousness on the Earth at this time. Stepping through the gateway in a figurative sense, allows you to move into your most evolved self, in oneness with all that is. We will offer suggestions and visualizations so your imagination can help you to create a beautiful scenario to empower this light-filled ritual. You have been coded within for this awakening moment. It is another step in the evolution of consciousness, one with great power and support. The archangels stand at the gateway to hold you in love while offering you strength and courage to step into your new awakened life. Since digital clocks have come into widespread usage, the image of 11-11 has become more familiar. The representation behind the symbol is less widely known. 11 has long been the number of the angelic realms offering assistance to those on the earth. When the 11s are seen together, the 11-11 becomes a gateway symbolizing heaven coming to earth, just as the peaks of a great mountain reach from the earth to the sky. The most important significance of the 11-11 is its availability as a gateway to higher consciousness, a moment in time where the angels of light can take your offered prayers and good intentions to assist their manifestation on the earth. Whenever the 11-11 presents itself, it acts as a daily reminder to take that 1 minute to hold your dreams in your heart, acknowledge the support available from the angelic realms, and have the courage to affirm your willingness to move into new dimensions of love. Gathering momentum throughout these past 25 years, a new level of union with your angelic self is available that offers a wondrous moment of ascending liberation from old patterns. The new opportunities available beyond the 11-11 gateway are greater awareness and the deeper truth of your choices and possibilities. The choice of many will be opting for the old way, and yet those who are attracted to this time of grace can avail themselves of the opportunity to soar, greatly empowered by the archangels. This is a ceremony of conscious intention, in harmony with divine light that will accelerate the evolution of consciousness within you and on the earth. Percolation and perturbation. It is a time of percolation and perturbation. New perceptions of reality percolate through the energy centers within you. Perturbation occurs as these new perceptions hit the coding in the imaginal system of your body in ways that stir you to change, like the metamorphosis of the caterpillar to a beautiful butterfly. The universe will stop at nothing to get your attention and encourage you to fulfill your soul's destiny. Perturbation is uncomfortable in its various demonstrations, making you feel very agitated. But know that all such catalysts are designed by your soul to bring you into a new level of evolution. Because the support of the angelic dimensions is so available, this portal offers you a graceful transition so you can see more clearly the world you are choosing to create on Earth while you assist its evolution. The 11-11 gateway to the fifth dimensional shifting of the ages allows a harmonious flow of divine love into your being. This can impact the amygdala in the temporal lobe of your brain in ways that calm this flight or fight center and cause it to resume the dimensions of your original divine blueprint. Over the years, this fear center has been overstimulated by the pressures, beliefs and electronics of this age. Much of what is called information is designed to increase the flow of fear energy to the center of the brain, causing it to increase in size. The resulting surge of imbalances, such as panic disorders, PTSD and more serious psychiatric conditions have become obviously rampant. The flow of divine love through each person can create an expansion in perception, as though the veils have parted so that new clarity dawns. This increase in clarity incites a sense of liberation and the freedom of spiritual expression within your being. Prayers for the earth to receive a positive benefit from this moment in time will be of great benefit. The release of pressure from the 11 to 11 gateway is similar to the beginnings of a horse race, when the horses are being held within the gate. As the gates are flung open, raw power surges forward and instincts take over. The rawness of this power requires careful training and guidance, so that it moves in directions that allow the goals to be reached and the reaping of rewards. Your prayers assist this process. The rewards from this time that we speak of are the prevalent desires of a heart seeking oneness, peace and harmony within your being. Access to these exalted states exist beyond the gateway. The archangels stand present, holding the forces of light as pillars at the gate. You can claim this empowerment of divine love to use within your own life. The intention of the 11 to 11 empowerment. The greater intention for this 11 to 11 empowerment has always been to ground divine energy. It is through you that it is meant to happen. Embodying the divine is our mission as we come into union with Source within each of us. Planetary evolution will prevail. It is made more graceful as millions of awakened people access the divine light through the gateways. Unity consciousness is the resulting force pervading the hearts of all humanity. Never doubt the miracle of spontaneous evolution as a creative possibility for the fifth dimensional shift on this planet. Asking for miracles at this time is very appropriate. The entwined spiral of the DNA is a strong image for this gateway experience. As the strands of the double helix intertwine in the subtle body, they connect the upper chakras and the energy sheath above the crown to universal presence. Spiraling down, they connect the crown chakra through the core of the body to the base chakra. They continue from the base of your spine below the earth and connect to the energy sheath beneath the earth, lighting up the 12 chakras of the subtle body. The image of the double helix of DNA strands acts as an allegory for the glyph of awakened consciousness as above, so below. This glyph represents embodied divinity upon an earth that has become sacred. There is also a deep connection to the flow of Kundalini spiritual energy as it winds through the energy centers of the body. This subtle linking involves the two centers below your base chakra and the three above your crown for the 12 chakras of subtle energy that are coming into completion with the 12 to 12. When you use this image, you are linking your most divine spiritual self with your human self, connected to the earth through the core of your being. Union with the self. The 11 to 11 gateway opens the way to this union within the self. You can use the image of the double helix to remind you of your alignment from heaven to earth. The archangels stand ready to welcome you into the new creative power of exalted awareness. Retraining and guiding the fearful thoughts that plague your days are only a prayer away. Each prayer raises your frequency of energy and could be the one that unleashes the critical mass for spontaneous evolution on the planet. Imagine that your prayer is the turning point, the key that fits the doorway to oneness. A prayer for your own personal 11 to 11 ceremony. Divine presence, all that is, and archangels of light, as I prepare to be guided through this 11-11 portal of time, I ask that the light of divine love clear any disharmony within my energy field. I willingly let go of the burdens of old beliefs so I may stand tall and move freely through the gateways to unity consciousness. within the spaciousness of my cleared energy field, I ask that it be filled with the power of divine love, harmony and peace. I ask to receive the strength and courage to embody these fields of divine light and ground the presence of love, peace and healing into the earth to assist her evolution. I join with the angelic dimensions and the millions of those who work in the light of God, as we are led through the 11-11 gateway. I know that as one is lifted up, all are uplifted. I allow new patterns of exalted light energy to engage my human structure in the completion of oneness union within my being with the divine. I dance through the light-filled gateways, feeling your guidance and knowing that loving awareness for new possibilities in my life will be provided in every moment, with every heartbeat. I awaken in your light and embrace the divine gifts being offered to me now with supreme gratitude. You are giving me the divine connection to greater life and I gratefully receive this. I am honored to anchor this light into the earth as the presence of nature awaits my awareness. Hold me with love and guide me as I step through this gateway into fifth dimensional awareness so I may use your divine love to bring greater life, peace and joy through my being and be a blessing for the earth. For this and all your blessings, I say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So be it so. Amen. The new levels of fifth dimensional awareness that are available beyond this gateway can impact all aspects of your being. You are being offered a supported and liberating path through these exalted portals to new territory for your soul's growth on earth. The 11-11 gateway is a supreme moment of time, yet the divine light causing evolution within you during this moment is a gift from a timeless reality that is in harmony with all of life. What words would you use to describe the current ride we are on? Emotionally exhausting? Mentally discombobulating? Spiritually exhilarating? Life more and more feels like a movie. A cosmic reality show kind of movie. Imagine the recruiting process, go to planet Earth. Humanity is about to experience the shift of the ages. They said. It'll be fun. They said. Everything out of date will collapse, and a whole new way of being will be born. It's a once-in-a-lifetime's opportunity. They promised. How exciting. We thought. They'll need truth revealers, freedom fighters, light warriors and star seeds to help the process, they said. That's us, let's go. We cried. Showtime should be around end 2012, said the production assistant. Great. We packed our bags and down the rainbow slide we slid. Shuffle of papers once 2012 came and went. Hello, anyone, what's happening? We wondered. Errr, said the production assistant. Turns out it's 2012 by the ancient calendar. That's 2020 by the modern one. To be specific, December 21, 2012 in the ancient calendar didn't fall until August 27, 2020 inches our modern calendar. Enter 2020. Okay, now we're talking. OHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHH Clever. Send everyone to their rooms so they can think about life, love and priorities. Intensify the control agenda so that people can really see it. Pull back the curtains to really reveal the puppet masters. And then, hey presto, everyone wakes up and reclaims their power and it's on to the new world. Only, oh no, some people aren't seeing. Some people aren't awakening. Oh no. Plot twist. Well, all good binge-worthy series have a plot twist or few. And they all keep you in suspense right until the end. They all make it look like there is no way for the good guys to win, until they do. Classic Hero's Journey, 101. All the award-winning movies use this model. Step 11 of 12, Resurrection. In which the last test is met. Here is the true climax of the story. Everything that happened prior to the stage culminates in a crowning test for the hero, as the dark side gets one last chance to triumph over the hero. From the 12 steps of the hero's journey, suffice it to say, at this point we're all pretty tired, and ready for step 12, return with the elixir, the triumphant homecoming. The Cosmic Reality Show producers are now making the script as ludicrous as possible in the final attempt to tell everyone, wake up. You're on a cosmic reality show. We're packing up the stage. It's time to move to the next season. They've inserted scenes like, if you are V'd you can drink standing up. Unless you're in a strip club then you have to drink sitting down. If you are V'd you can go to a concert with 10,000 people squeezed together. If you are not V'd you cannot visit your mother. These are actual rules in Australia. This is not a battle of the V'd vs the un-V'd. This is the final reveal of the real battle that's been going on for decades, centuries and millennia. It is between the minority who've had way too much power and control versus 99% of humanity. The minority have been super clever about it too, because it has been a covert battle. One which many people don't realize we're in, or feel too helpless to do anything about. In these final stages the minority have got very, very pushy. The irony is, the pushier they've become the more people have realized, I think there is something bigger going on here. Like all good movies, the win is never just handed over. The superheroes have to use their strength, courage, powers, intellect and instinct to save the day. Furthermore, as we see in the kids' movie Megamind, or as any elite athlete can tell you, often it is having an opponent that makes us rise to the occasion. The superheroes, regular people, are being galvanized into action and awakening by the very people who are seeking to intensify their control over them. So really, everyone is playing their role right now in the way they are meant to play it. Let's see what November's role is in all this. November is set to be a bumpy ride with so much planetary activity occurring directly opposite Uranus. Uranus is the planet of unexpected shocks, what the moments and events. He is the great awakener, creating sudden upheavals that ultimately result in new inventions and innovations. Uranus is also all about freedom. He is the light and the lightning that cracks open old, stagnant concrete, revealing the opportunities for something different. We can get comfy and familiar with the old. We may not have chosen to have a wrecking ball crash through our living room walls or lives. However, if it didn't crash through, we would never have seen that expansive new space on the other side. This theme officially started on November 5th with the new moon and sun opposite Uranus, however many of you would have felt, heard or seen the Mack truck coming a week or two earlier. This is such a tricky time emotionally for awakened souls. On the one hand, we know that collapses of the old are necessary, in order to birth the new. We know that shock revelations are part of the process, in order to get to the truth. However, we are human and as humans we feel grief, loss, shock, heartbreak, sadness, devastation. It's important to feel these feelings, while also having tools to ensure we don't set up camp there. While Uranus can certainly stir up some energy, it can feel a bit like you are plugged into an electrical socket that's giving you constant zaps. He also brings solutions and ideas that you might not have thought of before, or been ready for earlier. There is a saying, necessity is the mother of invention, which could well be Uranus's catch cry. Evolutionary leaps and revolutions have occurred because humanity is designed to grow. When we find ourselves in tight crevices, we are forced to think outside the box in order to survive and thrive. If there are situations going on within your life right now that have rocked you, ask the question, what is the opportunity here? What new ways, new processes, new patterns, new systems, new structures are ready to be birthed as a result of this? Uranus is over in earthy Taurus, so new ideas will be practical and grounded. Out of work teachers might now be gathering to ask, what new education systems can we create? Out of work healthcare workers might now be gathering to ask, what new holistic health systems can we create? Disillusioned families might now be gathering with like minds to leave their current geographical areas, moving to land in less populated areas, asking, what new communities and ways of living can we create? During November, the triggers for this change are over in Scorpio. Scorpio is ruled by Pluto, which is all about transformation and rebirth that comes from the death of the old, including old illusions, false facades, and outgrown versions of who you really are personally, and who we really are collectively. So this month you may see things you didn't, or couldn't, or weren't ready to see before. You may undergo excavations of the soul that are brutal yet liberating. This whole crazy episode titled Humanity Entering Its Next Chapter is ultimately taking us personally and collectively toward the fullest potential of who we really are. It will take us kicking and screaming, it will take us despite attempts to stop it. On November 13th, it's Mercury's turn to oppose Uranus. Take care with communication of any kind. Think before you speak or press send on that email. Uranus can be a little volatile, erratic and rebellious, so before you decide to shout at your boss, partner, family, I've had enough. I'm out of here. Take a breath. Ask yourself, what am I really upset about here? In what way do I feel my freedom is being restricted? What is a better way to express my needs? On November 18th, we have fiery Mars opposing Uranus, so take the Mercury advice above and times it by 10. Mars in Scorpio can sting, so people might be feeling particularly volatile if they find out that a secret has been kept from them. Reduce any urge to get revenge on someone that has hurt you. Once Mars moves into Sagittarius in mid-December, anyone who is standing on the side of truth will emerge the true victor, for lack of a better word. Mars can trigger anger and rage, so this is a good day to pen in some physical exercise to make sure you give your body a healthier way to unleash that energy. Please take care while driving. If you're feeling emotional, take a few deep breaths before you drive off upset. Mars is also all about action, which is great, but again, avoid doing anything impulsive that ends up hurting you or others in the end. A positive way to use this influence is to ask yourself questions like, what can I do to feel more free? What can I do to express myself more freely? What can I do to give myself and my family more freedom? Use the action-oriented influence of healthy Mars with the freedom-oriented influence of healthy Uranus. Also on November 18th, we have the transiting Moon in Taurus visiting Uranus as the Moon makes her way to the November 19th lunar eclipse. So that means that Mars will not only be opposite Uranus, but also opposite the Moon. This is a recipe for supercharged, explosive emotion and energy. Might be a good day to stay home under the covers. On a positive note, there is opportunity for something to come to a head that really needed to. If you've needed a good cry, this is the day for it, and it will feel like a good cleansing. Finally, we get to the November 19th lunar eclipse that's happening at 27 degrees of Taurus. Look for that point in your chart as well as 27 Scorpio, to see if it's likely to affect you. Usually an eclipse is the big event in months where they happen, but by this date we'll all be thinking, whatever, do your best. In a way, this lunar eclipse might come as a relief and a release. A release of any tension that has built up and has yet to come out. A closure to a situation that's been brewing. A final decision that has been on the cards. it can be a relief to finally be done with something and move on. We remain in the eclipse window until December 3rd, when we have the solar eclipse at 12 degrees of Sagittarius. That one feels so much better. Sagittarius clears the air with his devotion to truth, knowledge and spreading of wings. December alone has a completely different energy to the other 11 months of 2021. It is easy to think that these turbulent times are now a reality forever, but nothing lasts forever. We will get through this. How are you all feeling, dear ones? From the beginning of time there have been clear moments when the portals of awakening open for individuals to advance. The 11-11 gateway is a collective, high vibrational portal opening to assist the evolution of consciousness on the Earth at this time. Stepping through the gateway in a figurative sense, allows you to move into your most evolved self, in oneness with all that is. We will offer suggestions and visualizations so your imagination can help you to create a beautiful scenario to empower this light-filled ritual. You have been coded within for this awakening moment. It is another step in the evolution of consciousness, one with great power and support. The archangels stand at the gateway to hold you in love while offering you strength and courage to step into your new awakened life. Since digital clocks have come into widespread usage, the image of 11-11 has become more familiar. The representation behind the symbol is less widely known. 11 has long been the number of the angelic realms offering assistance to those on the earth. When the 11s are seen together, the 11-11 becomes a gateway symbolizing heaven coming to earth, just as the peaks of the great mountain reach from the earth to the sky. The most important significance of the 11-11 is its availability as a gateway to higher consciousness, a moment in time where the angels of light can take your offered prayers and good intentions to assist their manifestation on the earth. Whenever the 11-11 presents itself, it acts as a daily reminder to take that 1 minute to hold your dreams in your heart, acknowledge the support available from the angelic realms, and have the courage to affirm your willingness to move into new dimensions of love. Gathering momentum throughout these past 25 years, a new level of union with your angelic self is available that offers a wondrous moment of ascending liberation from old patterns. The new opportunities available beyond the 11-11 gateway are greater awareness and the deeper truth of your choices and possibilities. The choice of many will be opting for the old way, and yet those who are attracted to this time of grace can avail themselves of the opportunity to soar, greatly empowered by the archangels. This is a ceremony of conscious intention, in harmony with divine light that will accelerate the evolution of consciousness within you and on the earth. Percolation and perturbation. It is a time of percolation and perturbation. New perceptions of reality percolate through the energy centers within you. Perturbation occurs as these new perceptions hit the coding in the imaginal system of your body in ways that stir you to change, like the metamorphosis of the caterpillar to a beautiful butterfly. The universe will stop at nothing to get your attention and encourage you to fulfill your soul's destiny. Perturbation is uncomfortable in its various demonstrations, making you feel very agitated. But know that all such catalysts are designed by your soul to bring you into a new level of evolution. Because the support of the angelic dimensions is so available, this portal offers you a graceful transition so you can see more clearly the world you are choosing to create on Earth while you assist its evolution. The 11-11 gateway to the fifth dimensional shifting of the ages allows a harmonious flow of divine love into your being. This can impact the amygdala in the temporal lobe of your brain in ways that calm this flight or fight center and cause it to resume the dimensions of your original divine blueprint. Over the years, this fear center has been overstimulated by the pressures, beliefs, and electronics of this age. Much of what is called information is designed to increase the flow of fear energy to the center of the brain, causing it to increase in size. The resulting surge of imbalances, such as panic disorders, PTSD and more serious psychiatric conditions have become obviously rampant. The flow of divine love through each person can create an expansion in perception, as though the veils have parted so that new clarity dawns. This increase in clarity incites a sense of liberation and the freedom of spiritual expression within your being. Prayers for the earth to receive a positive benefit from this moment in time will be of great benefit. The release of pressure from the 11 to 11 gateway is similar to the beginnings of a horse race, when the horses are being held within the gate. As the gates are flung open, raw power surges forward and instincts take over. The rawness of this power requires careful training and guidance, so that it moves in directions that allow the goals to be reached and the reaping of rewards. Your prayers assist this process. The rewards from this time that we speak of are the prevalent desires of a heart seeking oneness, peace and harmony within your being. Access to these exalted states exists beyond the gateway. The archangels stand present, holding the forces of light as pillars at the gate. You can claim this empowerment of divine love to use within your own life. The intention of the 11 to 11 empowerment. The greater intention for this 11 to 11 empowerment has always been to ground divine energy. It is through you that it is meant to happen. Embodying the divine is our mission as we come into union with Source within each of us. Planetary evolution will prevail. It is made more graceful as millions of awakened people access the divine light through the gateways. Unity consciousness is the resulting force pervading the hearts of all humanity. Never doubt the miracle of spontaneous evolution as a creative possibility for the fifth dimensional shift on this planet. Asking for miracles at this time is very appropriate. The entwined spiral of the DNA is a strong image for this gateway experience. As the strands of the double helix intertwine in the subtle body, they connect the upper chakras and the energy sheath above the crown to universal presence. Spiraling down, they connect the crown chakra through the core of the body to the base chakra. They continue from the base of your spine below the earth and connect to the energy sheath beneath the earth, lighting up the 12 chakras of the subtle body. The image of the double helix of DNA strands acts as an allegory for the glyph of awakened consciousness as above, so below. This glyph represents embodied divinity upon an earth that has become sacred. There is also a deep connection to the flow of Kundalini spiritual energy as it winds through the energy centers of the body. This subtle linking involves the two centers below your base chakra and the three above your crown for the 12 chakras of subtle energy that are coming into completion with the 12 to 12. When you use this image, you are linking your most divine spiritual self with your human self, connected to the earth through the core of your being. Union with the Self. The 11 to 11 gateway opens the way to this union within the Self. You can use the image of the double helix to remind you of your alignment from heaven to earth. The archangels stand ready to welcome you into the new creative power of exalted awareness. Retraining and guiding the fearful thoughts that plague your days are only a prayer away. Each prayer raises your frequency of energy and could be the one that unleashes the critical mass for spontaneous evolution on the planet. Imagine that your prayer is the turning point, the key that fits the doorway to oneness. A prayer for your own personal 11 to 11 ceremony. Divine Presence, All That Is, and Archangels of Light, as I prepare to be guided through this 11-11 portal of time, I ask that the light of divine love clear any disharmony within my energy field. I willingly let go of the burdens of old beliefs so I may stand tall and move freely through the gateways to unity consciousness. Within the spaciousness of my cleared energy field, I ask that it be filled with the power of divine love, harmony and peace. I ask to receive the strength and courage to embody these fields of divine light and ground the presence of love, peace and healing into the earth to assist her evolution. I join with the angelic dimensions and the millions of those who work in the light of God, as we are led through the 11-to-11 gateway. I know that as one is lifted up, all are uplifted. I allow new patterns of exalted light energy to engage my human structure in the completion of oneness union within my being with the divine. I dance through the light-filled gateways, feeling your guidance and knowing that loving awareness for new possibilities in my life will be provided in every moment, with every heartbeat. I awaken in your light and embrace the divine gifts being offered to me now with supreme gratitude. You are giving me the divine connection to greater life and I gratefully receive this. I am honored to anchor this light into the earth as the presence of nature awaits my awareness. Hold me with love and guide me as I step through this gateway into fifth dimensional awareness so I may use your divine love to bring greater life, peace and joy through my being and be a blessing for the earth. For this and all your blessings, I say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So be it so. Amen. The new levels of fifth dimensional awareness that are available beyond this gateway can impact all aspects of your being. You are being offered a supportive and liberating path through these exalted portals to new territory for your soul's growth on earth. The 11-to-11 gateway is a supreme moment of time, yet the divine light causing evolution within you during this moment is a gift from a timeless reality that is in harmony with all of life. What words would you use to describe the current ride we are on? Emotionally exhausting? Mentally discombobulating? Spiritually exhilarating? Life more and more feels like a movie. A cosmic reality show kind of movie. Imagine the recruiting process, go to planet Earth. Humanity is about to experience the shift of the ages. They said. It'll be fun. They said. Everything out of date will collapse, and a whole new way of being will be born. It's a once-in-a-lifetime's opportunity. They promised. How exciting. We thought. They'll need truth revealers, freedom fighters, light warriors and star seeds to help the process, they said. That's us. Let's go. We cried. Showtime should be around end 2012, said the production assistant. Great. We packed our bags and down the rainbow slide we slid. Shuffle of papers once 2012 came and went. Hello, anyone, what's happening? We wondered. Errr, said the production assistant. Turns out it's 2012 by the ancient calendar. That's 2020 by the modern one. To be specific, December 21, 2012 in the ancient calendar didn't fall until August 27, 2020 inches our modern calendar. Enter 2020. Okay, now we're talking. OHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHHH Clever. Send everyone to their rooms so they can think about life, love and priorities. Intensify the control agenda so that people can really see it. Pull back the curtains to really reveal the puppet masters. And then, hey presto, everyone wakes up and reclaims their power and it's on to the new world. Only, oh no, some people aren't seeing. Some people aren't awakening. Oh no. Plot twist. Well, all good binge-worthy series have a plot twist or few. And they all keep you in suspense right until the end. They all make it look like there is no way for the good guys to win, until they do. Classic Hero's Journey, 101. All the award-winning movies use this model. Step 11 of 12, Resurrection. In which the last test is met. Here is the true climax of the story. Everything that happened prior to the stage culminates in a crowning test for the hero, as the dark side gets one last chance to triumph over the hero. From the 12 steps of the hero's journey, suffice it to say, at this point we're all pretty tired, and ready for step 12, return with the elixir, the triumphant homecoming. The Cosmic Reality Show producers are now making the script as ludicrous as possible in a final attempt to tell everyone, wake up. You're on a cosmic reality show. We're packing up the stage. It's time to move to the next season. They've inserted scenes like, if you are V'd you can drink standing up. Unless you're in a strip club then you have to drink sitting down. If you are V'd you can go to a concert with 10,000 people squeezed together. If you are not V'd you cannot visit your mother. These are actual rules in Australia. This is not a battle of the V'd vs the un-V'd. This is the final reveal of the real battle that's been going on for decades, centuries and millennia. It is between the minority who've had way too much power and control versus 99% of humanity. The minority have been super clever about it too, because it has been a covert battle. One which many people don't realize we're in, or feel too helpless to do anything about. In these final stages the minority have got very, very pushy. The irony is, the pushier they've become the more people have realized, I think there is something bigger going on here. Like all good movies, the win is never just handed over. The superheroes have to use their strength, courage, powers, intellect and instinct to save the day. Furthermore, as we see in the kids' movie Megamind, or as any elite athlete can tell you, often it is having an opponent that makes us rise to the occasion. The superheroes, regular people, are being galvanized into action and awakening by the very people who are seeking to intensify their control over them. So really, everyone is playing their role right now in the way they are meant to play it. Let's see what November's role is in all this. November is set to be a bumpy ride with so much planetary activity occurring directly opposite Uranus. Uranus is the planet of unexpected shocks, what the moments and events. He is the great awakener, creating sudden upheavals that ultimately result in new inventions and innovations. Uranus is also all about freedom. He is the light and the lightning that cracks open old, stagnant concrete, revealing the opportunities for something different. We can get comfy and familiar with the old. We may not have chosen to have a wrecking ball crash through our living room walls or lives. However, if it didn't crash through, we would never have seen that expansive new space on the other side. This theme officially started on November 5th with the new moon and sun opposite Uranus. However, many of you would have felt, heard or seen the Mack truck coming a week or two earlier. This is such a tricky time emotionally for awakened souls. On the one hand, we know that collapses of the old are necessary, in order to birth the new. We know that shock revelations are part of the process, in order to get to the truth. However, we are human and as humans we feel, grief, loss, shock, heartbreak, sadness, devastation. It's important to feel these feelings, while also having tools to ensure we don't set up camp there. While Uranus can certainly stir up some energy, it can feel a bit like you are plugged into an electrical socket that's giving you constant zaps. He also brings solutions and ideas that you might not have thought of before, or been ready for earlier. There is a saying, necessity is the mother of invention, which could well be Uranus's catch cry. Evolutionary leaps and revolutions have occurred because humanity is designed to grow. When we find ourselves in tight crevices, we are forced to think outside the box in order to survive and thrive. If there are situations going on within your life right now that have rocked you, ask the question, what is the opportunity here? What new ways, new processes, New patterns, new systems, new structures are ready to be birthed as a result of this. Uranus is over in earthy Taurus, so new ideas will be practical and grounded. Out of work teachers might now be gathering to ask, what new education systems can we create? Out of work healthcare workers might now be gathering to ask, what new holistic health systems can we create? Disillusioned families might now be gathering with like minds to leave their current geographical areas, moving to land in less populated areas, asking, what new communities and ways of living can we create? During November, the triggers for this change are over in Scorpio. Scorpio is ruled by Pluto, which is all about transformation and rebirth that comes from the death of the old, including old illusions, false facades, and outgrown versions of who you really are personally, and who we really are collectively. So this month you may see things you didn't, or couldn't, or weren't ready to see before. You may undergo excavations of the soul that are brutal yet liberating. This whole crazy episode titled Humanity Entering Its Next Chapter is ultimately taking us personally and collectively toward the fullest potential of who we really are. It will take us kicking and screaming, it will take us despite attempts to stop it. On November 13th, it's Mercury's turn to oppose Uranus. Take care with communication of any kind. Think before you speak or press send on that email. Uranus can be a little volatile, erratic and rebellious, so before you decide to shout at your boss, partner, family, I've had enough. I'm out of here. Take a breath. Ask yourself, what am I really upset about here? In what way do I feel my freedom is being restricted? What is a better way to express my needs? On November 18th, we have fiery Mars opposing Uranus, so take the Mercury advice above and times it by 10. Mars and Scorpio can sting, so people might be feeling particularly volatile if they find out that a secret has been kept from them. Reduce any urge to get revenge on someone that has hurt you. Once Mars moves into Sagittarius in mid-December, anyone who is standing on the side of truth will emerge the true victor, for lack of a better word. Mars can trigger anger and rage, so this is a good day to pen in some physical exercise to make sure you give your body a healthier way to unleash that energy. Please take care while driving. If you're feeling emotional, take a few deep breaths before you drive off upset. Mars is also all about action, which is great, but again, avoid doing anything impulsive that ends up hurting you or others in the end. A positive way to use this influence is to ask yourself questions like, what can I do to feel more free? What can I do to express myself more freely? What can I do to give myself and my family more freedom? Use the action-oriented influence of healthy Mars with the freedom-oriented influence of healthy Uranus. Also on November 18th, we have the transiting moon in Taurus visiting Uranus as the moon makes her way to the November 19th lunar eclipse. So that means that Mars will not only be opposite Uranus, but also opposite the moon. This is a recipe for supercharged, explosive emotion and energy. Might be a good day to stay home under the covers. On a positive note, there is opportunity for something to come to a head that really needed to. If you've needed a good cry, this is the day for it, and it will feel like a good cleansing. Finally, we get to the November 19th lunar eclipse that's happening at 27 degrees of Taurus. Look for that point in your chart as well as 27 Scorpio, to see if it's likely to affect you. Usually an eclipse is the big event in months where they happen, but by this date we'll all be thinking, whatever, do your best. In a way, this lunar eclipse might come as a relief and a release. A release of any tension that has built up and has yet to come out. A closure to a situation that's been brewing. A final decision that has been on the cards. It can be a relief to finally be done with something and move on. We remain in the eclipse window until December 3rd, when we have the solar eclipse at 12 degrees of Sagittarius. That one feels so much better. Sagittarius clears the air with his devotion to truth, knowledge and spreading of wings. December alone has a completely different energy to the other 11 months of 2021. It is easy to think that these turbulent times are now a reality forever, but nothing lasts forever.
Hello galactic
family. We will
family.
Get through this.
Hello to
How are
all
you all
feeling?
Like Gaia Planetary Station, I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning in the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store, search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.